نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah. We seek refuge with Allah from our sins and bad deeds. He who is guided by Allah indeed has been guided. And he who is misguided, only Allah Azza wa Jal can guide him. And I bear witness that there is no deity to be worshipped except Allah. And I bear witness that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon Sayyidina Muhammad, upon his family, upon his companions, and upon those who follow his sunnah until the day of judgment. The best words are the words of Allah, and the best guidance is the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We're here celebrating Eid, celebrating the time of sacrifice, the time that Ibrahim alayhi salam listened, responded, had submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do an action that is an action of obedience, because it is a command of Allah. But if it wasn't the command of Allah, it would be an action of a disobedient. It would have been a criminal action of killing his own son. But that which as a command of Allah does not come through our intellect. It comes through our intellect, we think about it to verify if it is the command of Allah or the command of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then we go on and implement. Even Shaitan knew this. Shaitan stood in the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam to stop them from going through with it. Even though Shaitan would whisper to mankind to disobey and to kill and take a life, but he knew that taking this life is an action of obedience. Knew that otherwise a sinful action, this is the most obedience of action. So he appeared to Ibrahim alayhi salam to tempt him to stop doing this, that taking away your son, the one that Allah has given you, the one that is going to grow up and spread the deen, you know. Now that Shaitan is giving an advice to stop the ultimate surrender and Islam and submitting to Allah, And Ibrahim alayhi salam threw him with a stone, appeared to Ismail alayhi salam, and he was thrown again with a stone, appeared to the mother of Ismail alayhi salam, and he was thrown with a stone. And when the matter became a total submission with Ibrahim alayhi salam, with Ismail alayhi salam, with the mother of Ismail alayhi salam, with all were involved in the matter, سمعنا وأطعنا, we hear and we obey. And that is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Ibrahim, يا إبراهيم قد صدقت الرؤيا, O Ibrahim, you have fulfilled the ru'ya that we have given you, the dream we have given you. You passed the test. وَإِذِ ابْتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنَّ. When Allah tested Ibrahim عليه السلام, was tested with words, and he completed them. That was the completion. Since he was young until he became very old, he was tested with mihan and tribulations and commands one after another, and he completed them. Then Allah told him, إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. I am making you an imam to mankind now. Now you get this honor. قَالَ وَمِن ذُرِّيَّتِي. He said, and from my offsprings, Ya Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا يَنَالُ عَهْدِ الظَّالِمِينَ. Those who are unjust will not receive this covenant. So it is not because they're going to be your children and the children of your children. It's not because they're going to be your progeny. They will inherit this. No. This inheritance of this covenant with Allah is an inheritance with obedience, is inheritance with sami'na wa ata'na, is not an inheritance with blood relation. And when Ibrahim alayhi salam was making dua, رَبِّ جَعَلْ هَذَا بَلَدًا آمِنًا, O Allah, makes this a safe city, وَارْزُقْ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ, and give and sustenance from all fruits to the inhabitants of this place. Then he remembered the answer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before, لَا يَنَالُ عَهْدِ الظَّالِمِينَ. So he said, مَنْ آمَنَ مِنْهُمْ. So Ibrahim alayhi salam is like making an exception. Give rizq to those who believe from among them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ كَفَرْ. And the kafir as well we will give them. Why? Because this asking is for the rizq of this dunya. This ask is, this dua saying, وَرْزُقْ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ. The ahl of the people of this town, give them from the thamarat of this dunya. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ كَفَرْ. Those who are kuffar will give them too. That is a covenant that Allah has for mankind because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them. Allah gives the believers, gives the disbelievers, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is their Rabb. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is their caretaker. But the covenant, the first one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنِّي جَعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. This making Ibrahim alayhi salam imam to mankind and all the prophets and messengers of Allah after them, those who follow them will get this covenant. This covenant has to do with work, has to do with submission, has to do with sami'na wa ata'na. Then they started building the Kaaba, Ibrahim wa Ismail alayhim as-salam. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتُ وَإِسْمَعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. When Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam was putting up the foundation, putting it up, meaning building the Kaaba, they saying, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. O Allah, accept from us. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. You are all hearing and all knowing. Meaning you hear us, Ya Allah, when we make dua, and you know that, Ya Allah, our sincerity, if we are sincere or not. You know what the chests are hiding. And then they continued in the dua. رَبَّنَا وَبْعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ. رَبَّنَا وَجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ. And make us Muslimin to you. ومن ذريتنا أمة مسلمة لك. And from our offsprings ummah that is Muslima to you, Ya Allah. And what is the dua after that? ربنا وابعث فيهم رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياتك ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة ويزكيهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم. Oh Allah, bring from among them a Rasul, a messenger. يعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة, teaches them the book and the sunnah. الكتاب والحكمة, the wisdom, the Quran and sunnah. ويزكيهم and purify them. إنك أنت السميع, إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم. You are almighty, العزيز and حكيم and all wise. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered their dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the last messenger for all mankind, Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the complete way of life, a complete religion. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم. Today I completed your religion for you, your deen for you. وأتممت عليكم نعمتي, and completed our my bounty upon you. ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا, and I am pleased. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, and I am pleased with Islam for you as a deen. إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. The deen with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الإسلام. ومن إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. ومن يبتغي غير الإسلام دينا فلن يقبل منه. And the one who will try to seek a religion beside Islam, فلن يقبل منه. It will not be accepted from them. وهو في الآخرة من الخاسرين. And he is at the day in the akhirah, in the hereafter, from those who are losers. When did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلُوا آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْنَا وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَأَعْقُوبَ وَالْأَسْبَاطِ وَمَا أُوتِيَ مُوسَى وَعِيسَى وَمَا أُوتِيَ النَّبِيُّونَ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ لا نفرق بين أحد منهم ونحن له مسلمون. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they would say to us, say, we believe in what came down on us and what came down on all the prophets that was just mentioned, Ibrahim wa Ismail wa Ishaq wa Yaqub wa Asbat, all the messenger and Isa wa Musa, meaning all the messengers of Allah, they have received the religion of Islam from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Called mankind to follow the religion of Islam. Some followed and some did not follow. Time passes, the deen of Islam changes. Then Allah sends another messenger with the deen of Islam. Some follow, some do not follow. Time passes and the matter changes. Then Allah sends another messenger and another messenger until the last messenger of Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the deen of Islam through the Quran that will never change, through the sunnah that will never change, that will be kept the way it is until the day of judgment. Now the religion of Islam, a religion that is clear for all mankind until the day of judgment. This is our deen. This is the deen of Isa wa Musa wa Ibrahim wa Ismail wa Ishaq wa al-Asbat. The deen of Allah. The deen of La ilaha illallah. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا يُحِبُّونَهُمْ كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. And from among the people who take partners with Allah, they love them like they love Allah. But those who are believers, they have more intense love to Allah. Love that moves us on earth, moves us to do actions. Allah, Ibrahim alayhi salam loved Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than his son. So he went to slaughter his son in the way of Allah. Ismail alayhi salam loved Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than his father. So he told his father, Ya abati faal ma tu'mar, satajiduni inshaAllah min as-sabirin. Oh my dear father, do what you are asked. Go ahead and slaughter me. And you will find me inshaAllah from those who are patient. The mother of Ibrahim alayhi salam loved Allah more than she loved her son and loved her husband. Go and do what Allah commanded you to do. This is our deen, to love Allah more than anything, more than our wives, our children, more than anything in this world. The love that is by choice, once it is called Allah, then we do. Once it is called Rasul, then we do. Yes, we have love toward our children. Allah compliment this love and our family. And that love is a good love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not deny us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not belittle this love. Allah put it in our heart that made Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam shed a tear when he was burying his own son Ibrahim. Because he loved him so much. Because the rahmah, the mercy in the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is in abundance. That love is okay to have. But once you are confronted with the love that is in your heart and the love that you should have to Allah, the love that you should have to Allah by choice must prevail over the love that you have toward anything. That is the fitan that we have. That is the tribulation that we have. And the word love continues throughout the Quran. Okay. So those who were in Medina, they loved those who came to make hijrah from Mecca to them. يُحِبُّونَ وَلَا يَجِدُونَ فِي صُدُورِهِمْ حَاجَةً مِمَّا أُوتُوا يُحِبُّونَ مَنْ هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِمْ. They loved those who made hijrah to them. That love that they had toward one another. And they did not find in their hearts something to be miser about. They give it up for their brethren, even though it was very special and very personal. But they give it for their brothers. Why? Because they loved them. In the way of Allah. They loved Allah by choice. And they loved their brethren by choice. They loved them before they saw them. They did not know them personally, but they had a common denominator with them. What is it? La ilaha illallah. We all here should love one another by choice. Why? Because we are holding to La ilaha illallah. Even though it is the first time we see one another, even though we do not know the name of one another, but because we are praying with one another together, love should be in our heart. More than the love over anything, because it is from the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فأصبحتم بنعمته إخوانا. And remember the bounty that Allah has upon you. Okay. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you love one another, made you be brethren after you were the enemy of one another. It is from Allah, this unity from Allah. The world was changed by the companions when they loved one another for the sake of Allah. Because they knew that when they implement the commands of Allah, when they implement the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and when they love one another for the sake of Allah, they knew that Allah is with them. And if they wanted to move mountains, it will move by the will of Allah now. And that is not exclusive to them. It is for all of us at any time in history until the day of judgment. In any time to come until the day of judgment. The ikhlas that we can reach in our heart. The sincerity that we can reach in our heart. So we could really do the work of Allah for the sake of Allah and really love one another for the sake of Allah. And that sincerity, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know it. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know it. An angel does not know it to write it, nor a shaitan knows it to spoil it. It is in the heart, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows it. And once it is there, success follows. The love that al-Muhajireen and al-Ansar had for one another, there it was sincere, and success came to them because of this sincerity. وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِن بَعْدِهِمْ. And those who came after them, who are they? Us. After mentioning al-Muhajireen, after mentioning al-Ansar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us this honor to mention us with al-Muhajireen and al-Ansar. وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِن بَعْدِهِمْ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَا بِالْإِيمَانِ رَبَّنَا وَلَا تَجْعَلْ غِلًّا فِي قُلُوبِنَا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. Oh our Lord, forgive us and forgive those who came before us when they were Muslims. Meaning, we're looking at those who came in the past and we love them because they're holding on to La ilaha illallah. And we say, Allah, forgive us and forgive them. And then we love those who are with us now. Oh Allah, do not have any, allow any ill feeling come to our heart, ghil between us and those who are believers. Meaning, Allah, give us that love between us, just like you give the love between the Muhajireen and Al-Ansar. They came before us, we love them, and now we are all together and we love one another. Oh Allah, do not allow something of ill feeling to come into our heart for one another. That is the quality. That is the quality to change. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah will not change what's happening to people unless they change what's happening within themselves. The changes are two. What changes happening to us, Allah will do it with a condition that you change what's happening within yourself. Again, within oneself. Again, love Allah and love each other. And love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the changes will happen from outside. We're coming to times that are special times. That's what's happening in one place in the earth is known in the extreme place in the earth, in another area in the opposite direction of the earth. Muslimin is being mentioned, Muslim and Islam, in every minute in the world, in the news today. And it has been for a while. Not 1 minute passes except the word Islam and Muslims are mentioned. We need to hold Islam dear to our heart and know that we are the ambassador of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth with the religion of Islam. The way we conduct ourselves and the way we behave in all aspects of life should indicate that beautiful way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a beautiful way of the Quran, the beautiful way of Islam. And pressure is coming upon Muslimin everywhere, to the point that many of us is now talking in an apology all the time. No, 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 we're not this. No, 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 we're not that. No, 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 this. And no, 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 that. No, we need to stop that. Okay? We're not responsible for anybody else and whatever they're doing. We cannot apologize for anyone else. But we say we are about this and we are doing this. And this way is the best way. And we do not shy from this. And we hold on to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we say, yes, we are Sunnis, following the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we say that the way to Allah is only one way, the way that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam shows us. And we should not be shy away from that. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put love in our heart for each other. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show us the straight path and help us to go on it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show us the wrong path and help us not to go on it. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to build the community that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to protect one another in the way of Allah, and to raise our children in the way of Allah, and to help us in this life to be qualified to enter Jannah in the hereafter. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم أنت أعلم بما في قلوبنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم أنت أعلم بحاجتنا منا فاقضِ لنا حاجتنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم أنت أعلم بسرنا وعلانيتنا فتقبل معذرتنا. اللهم اجعلنا هادين مهتدين غير ضالين ولا مضلين. اللهم اجعل إيمانا صادقا في قلوبنا حتى نعلم أنه لا يصيبنا إلا ما كتبته لنا ولا ننال إلا ما كتبته لنا. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. واللهم تقبل منا ومنكم صالح الدعاء وصالح الأعمال يا رب العالمين. والحمد لله رب العالمين. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. جزاكم الله خيرا.